obsessed with you in a way I can't believe. When you wipe your tears, do you wipe them just for me?
Is dishes. I hate dishes. I will scrub toilets with my bare hands, but I won't do dishes.
Hey, Muhammad, what are you doing?
What's up?
What are you doing?
I'm washing the dishes, bro.
No, you're not supposed to. You're not supposed to do this.
No, no, that's okay.
You're
like
a salesman, bro.
No, it's actually one of my hobbies. I like to do this in my free time, too. Like, washing the dishes is something I like to do in my free time, so I don't mind doing it, like, all the time. So, yeah, it's okay. I'll do the salesman stuff later. Like, just let me wash the dishes right now. All right.
انا لبناني والله وعبلادي بموت والله بالدنيا ما في مثلك بيروت
Now look at me and this opportunity is standing right in front of me. One thing I know, it's only part luck and
this trend. Dreams wrinkle silk on my cheeks. I don't see nobody but you.
Questions I get asked as a Hawaiian Muslima.
Oh yeah, I got it in my purse for you right now. I brought it just for you. Because I knew you was going to ask me for it. I don't have it with me.
Three things that people think is haram but it really isn't. Number one, not having kids.
Number two, seeing Mufti Mank without his thobe.
المحترم احترمه وليغلط اشرب دمه.
I remember when I lost my mind.
I'm actually really happy that this video is up because I have a similar story that I've been wanting to tell. Went to a homie's house for iftar, met his family, his grandma, his aunts, his cousins, and his uncle. So me and the uncle, we strike up a conversation. We're talking about everything, basketball, religion, politics, everything. So we get from the conversation that, like, this is a cool guy, you know, we vibe. This is my close friend, so he texts me, he says, hey, come for iftar again. My uncle has a present for you. So obviously I do the whole, nah, don't give it to me. But you know, inevitably I go and homie's like, okay, the present's big, so it's in my trunk. In your trunk? Oh, okay. So I walk with him to the trunk. He busts it open and let me show you what the uncle got. I don't know who this is. I don't know what the correlation between me and him is. But somehow, like, he saw this and was reminded of me. And for that, I said thanks.
Thank you. كوكب النور دعانا أقدم دار أطرحانا عروة الدين تنادي.
Yes, you can hoop, but can you camel jump?
So when I first saw this, I was like, big whoop. I'm sure anybody can jump a camel, right? And then I severely miscalculated how tall a camel is. So at the tip of the hump, a camel is about 2.13 meters tall, which is about 7 feet. To put that into perspective, LeBron James can jump 40 inches, which is only about 3 feet. These guys in the middle of the Yemeni desert can jump double LeBron. And it's starting to make sense why Trump put that travel ban on Muslim countries, because if these guys come to America, the NBA is done. They're dunking on all of you.
Like, may Allah pray for this ummah, because these hijabis are lost nowadays. Like, I'm not one of them, because it's like, I can't even find friends. I can't fit in because they're all like haram, and I'm just like such a good innocent hijabi. Oh my God, what are you doing? You can't Snapchat me.
Oh, sorry.
Hold on a second. My mom is an Islamic studies teacher, so I'm gonna show you our wine glasses that we use it for halal stuff. First of all, we have the tequila cup. I mean, this is just born for tequila, come on. Next thing, we have a wine glass. This is for wine, come on, this is for wine. This one is my personal favorite because, come on. A beer glass, because why not? Tell me that you would never drink vodka from this, come on. But you know, we keep it halal. We drink water or Pepsi from it. Okay, we have another wine glass. I mean, come on. This must be used for mojitos. And I'm not talking about the virgin mojitos. But we use it for ice cream. Another super fancy beer glass. Come on. And another beer glass. I have no idea what you would drink with this, but come on. Looks haram. Let me take you to the cabinet, because this is where the real haram stuff is at. This is the cabinet that if you open it, you would die. Okay, so we have a wine glass. And we have these dirty martini glasses. Because why not? And that is it. Just remember, drink just water or any other kind of drink that is halal.
What we doing? Okay, shawty, editing up. I want her friend. Want her friend. I might pull up. I might pull up. In a bin. In a bin. Tell him what's up. Tell him what's up. Tell him it's on. Tell him it's on.
Yo, what do you do for a living?
Huh?
What do you do for a living?
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
What do you do for a living?
No.
I was patient, yeah. Oh, I was patient. Hey, oh. Now I can scream that we made it.
People who are named Muhammad but go by Mo in the entire United States light skin community are the same type of people. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
That ain't nothing.
I want my twin finna blow me a bag of Benny, man. They go pop a crib in Miami. Hello. I'm on the pack. Off of that bitch, I'm a Leo. I get the money, no Leo. I move the pack through the mail. She give me bread till I mail. Off of that bitch, I'm a Leo.
Your parents want you to look like versus what you want to look like.
She fancy Mona Lisa.
Yamanamadu, Yamanamamu, Lamagamagu, Gamagu. And I'm a bebop, Gamma Juice, Yabba da Baba, when the beat drop, beat drop. A Yabba Dabba Doobop, a Yabba da Baba da Wada Woop, a Wada Suwada Mada Woop.
Some random girl joined in from the back.
My body shaped like genie, booty dreamy, waist is teeny. Yes, I told him to get titles, so he streamy when he leave me. I go hard in the booth. Biggie.
No, because like when you're literally about to like, you know when I was like,
big cap, damn homie, where's the drip at? Got this chick in the car, she complaining too much. Told her sit back, sit back. Gave her some yak, told her relax. Boom bow, that's how you fix that.
اسكت يا قلبي ده انت اللي جايب لي مصايب بتعاشر ناس
shit pissed me off for real. Why do you act like that?
Like what?
The way that you act, you don't see how you act, why people don't want to be around you?
No.
Look how you act.
Putting on chapstick like it's lipstick.
Let me just put on some chapstick.
Why do you need a camera to put on chapstick? It's chapstick.
Uh-huh.
First of all, ew, why are you applying it like that?
I'm just trying to put on chapstick. Like, what? I have chap lips.
So apply it normally. Why are you dabbing it on? It's not lipstick.
Oh.
There's nothing in the corner of your mouth.
I'm trying to get full coverage. Can I just get full coverage?
It's petroleum jelly. There is no full coverage. Mm. You can't be serious. Right now, you can't be that.
All right, we're done. Okay, let's start the video.
Are we done? You want some lip liner to go along with that?
Do you have some?
I do.
I hear your heartbeat to the beat of the drums. Oh, how to say.
The school counselor sent me here. Okay, I don't actually need therapy. She thinks I do though.
Remind me why you're here again.
Oh, it's simple, really. I just go for a dice roll. Okay, I'll tell you. Maybe we were in chemistry class, and maybe I set a girl's hair on fire. Is it because I'm a hijabi? Racist?
No, maybe it's because she was sent to the ER and has second degree burns.
Okay, look, I'm not one to talk. I know hijab and everything. She wasn't having a good hair day anyway. I think I did her a favor.
No.
And you know what else? She's an INTJ. You know whose personality type that is?
No.
Hitler. It's like the same thing as like, if you went back to the future and you saw Hitler as a baby, would you kill Hitler? Yes you would. Yes you would. Do you support the Holocaust? Yeah. Exactly. You know what? You're probably pro-Israeli.
I do not discuss politics.
You know, I'm kind of sensing INTJ vibes from you.
I actually am an INTJ.
My hijab fell off on this ride.
Look into my eyes. Great, now that I have your attention, something's been on my mind lately. I'm growing up and I'm becoming a woman now, and I'm gonna have to start going to my own doctor's appointments. Like, I have to talk to the doctor directly. I can't tell my mom what's wrong with me so that she can talk to the doctor for me. Like, my mom isn't there. Who am I gonna speak to? I'm not gonna speak to the doctor. That's so weird. Maybe I can hire like a manager so that they can act like my mom. Not that I have mommy issues. Maybe I could just not go to the doctors at all. I would be saving money.
Me getting a Nike Pro. Hijab thinking I'm gonna. Look like one of those. Athletic Nike He Hobby models.
Okay guys, we're doing another hijab tutorial. So first we're gonna put on the normal one, right? It's like this, and it's like this. Obviously I'm gonna do this tutorial on me because I can't show my hair. And then we're gonna put the bandanas, okay? One bandana goes like this. Wait, cause it's two bandanas. Oh my god, like I need to hurry this up. And then the other bandana goes like this. Wait, oops. I wore this like a couple weeks ago. And then there's another one that maybe ties it all together and it goes like this. Wait. It's gonna tie, I'm gonna do one quick fix and it's gonna do something. But then you first have to put this one on. It's gonna be a quick fix. It's gonna come together at the end. Don't trip. It's gonna come together.
The joke here. Look like a Samoan.
Then you're gonna do like this. See, so these two both are down. And then, to make it like not look so intense, we're gonna put a pink one to tie it like this.
Yes, here.
And then we get the black hijab. And we put it like this. Wait, no. Put your chin up. Chin up! Chin up, you stupid butt. Okay, you go like this. You know? And then just to top it all off, you become a towel head to fit all the stereotypes of Akijani. Sorry.
That you can read his astrological birth chart, but you can't read the red flags.
I know, miss. I saw the signs and I ignored it. Isn't talking right now.
You know what's so crazy to me? This is like the second time this has happened to me at work. Like, customers won't ask where I'm from. I'm just like, oh, I'm from Peru and I speak Spanish, whatever. And they're like, oh my gosh, you speak Spanish and you're Muslim, like, blah, blah, blah. And you know, I'll tell them I'm a convert. And then somehow when I say that, they're like, oh, are you married? Do I have a ring on my finger? No. Like, bro, why would you assume that? Because you think I converted for guy? No. It doesn't make me upset or anything. It's just funny. Also, you know what I like doing? When I hear people like speaking Spanish in the store, I'll be like, hi, ¿cómo estás? Necesitan algo? And they'll be like, oh. I do that every single time because the shock on their faces never gets old.
Shit pissed me off for real. Why do you act like that?
Like what?
The way that you act. You don't see how you act, why people don't want to be around you?
No.
Look how you act. Mm-hmm.
I brought you frankincense.
Thank you.
And I brought you myrrh.
Thank you.
Murder. Judas. No.
We shouting out my block, cause bitch, that's where I started. Ahead of my class, yeah, I always been the smartest.
If you like smoking weed, let me hear you say hell yeah.
Gotcha. Get these motherfuckers.
Let me see you. Shut that ass.
Show yourself in baggy clothes then in a bikini.
Ya Rabb al Alameen, Allah.
What?
Not only did you say remove your hijab, you're also telling me to leave Islam. The reason why so many girls remove the hijab and so many people leave Islam is because of these type of people. You guys act like Allah left you in charge. Chao, anyway, so I am not leaving Islam and I'm most definitely not taking my hijab off because I know this is not part of Islam. And to all my girls, whether you wear the hijab or not, keep doing you and do what makes you happy.
Hope no one heard that. I hope no one heard that. Cause if they did, we gon' be in some trouble. Yeah.
You
gon' make me need bail, you know that. Car tripping with your friend, you ain't even had me lying on your
Sham ghazab ki hangama khiz hai
iska nasha hi gehra hai tez hai
Sham ghazab ki hangama khiz hai
iska nasha hi gehra hai tez hai
zulf khuli hai resham resham
saans khuli hai matha matha
ye to ishaare hai
aklo hosh nami danam hum hai dil hai yaar janam
What can I do with my honey? What can I do? She is funny. What can I do with my honey? What can I do? She is funny. What can I do with my honey? What can I do with my honey? What can I do with my honey? What can I do? She is funny. What can I do with my honey? What can I do? She is funny. What can I do with my honey? What can I do with my honey?
Rose-tinted dreams, wrinkled silk on my sheets. I don't see nobody but you.
Hey besties, so my mother-in-law just came back from Turkey and I asked her for like a prayer thing, like a prayer robe, because the thing with me is I feel like I struggle with prayers. The hardest thing about praying is having to go find like a hijab and then like the robe, and you know, like all of that is the hard part and like what makes you unmotivated to pray. So she got me this. First of all, it's so thin and like comfortable. It's like the best, most silky cotton material. It's delicious. And so yeah, I love that. But wait a second. By the way, sorry, this is taking a long time, but also pros of having a mother-in-law that lives, that travels overseas often, because she brought me so much like halal stuff as well. Like halal stuff, I mean like modest clothes. And it just like hits different. Okay, give me one second, let me figure this out. And then oh me hold on, let me figure it out and then I'll, okay, I got it. So basically it's like this hoodie like this, I look like a Taze. How do you say Taze in Arabic? Like auntie. I be looking like an auntie. But you guys, this is so convenient. Like, my face looks big too with hijab. Like, I be struggling with that. Like, I feel like it emphasizes my face. Also, this has patterns, so it kind of makes me look more, you know what I mean? But like, look how easy this is. Like, I can just pray like this, you know what I mean? And my hair is also not sticking out. It's fully covered, and I didn't even put my hair up. And it also covers your chest with this. When you go like this, when you're going like, you know, like this, it doesn't show either. Purr.
Here are some rules for my wife. Now, I'm not planning on getting married for another 2, maybe 3,000 years. But everyone in Zerteta is on the strand, so yalla bina. Rule number one, Zadeen. You know, just like me, I want someone who loves Zadeen. Rule number two, you have to be smart. يعني I'm not asking for Einstein or rocket ships ومش عارف ايه. بس if she is slow, then she gets no ghetto. Rule number three, and maybe the most important rule, we are getting a cat and naming her Mishmish. This rule is non-negotiable. It's either me and Mishmish or nothing at all. Thank you for watching.
Why I became Muslim instead of atheist. My dad passed away when I was 11. I never said goodbye. Islam gave me hope of seeing him again in heaven. Life doesn't end after D3S. I promise to be the best daughter for you, Baba.
أنا لأهلي أنا أفديهم أنا دمي فلسطيني 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 أنا دمي فلسطيني على أهدي على ديني على أرضي تلاقيني أنا لأهلي أنا أفديهم أنا دمي فلسطيني 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 أنا دمي فلسطيني
بس